Good morning all of you. Today we will start exercise 3B of chapter 3, square and square root. The first question of this exercise is by prime factorization method, find the square root of the number. This is the number. For prime factorization, we have to find the square root by prime factorization method. So let's start. 2 1s are, this is 2 4s are 8, 2 5s are 10, 2 8s are 16, 2 7s are 14, 2 2s are 4, 2 9s are 18, 3 2s are 6, 3 4s are 12, 3 3s are 9, 3 8s are 24, 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 3 7s are 21, 3 9s are 27, 3 3s are 10, 3 1s are. Write down the factor of 2 9 1 6. Factors of 2 9 1 6 are
2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3.
Since we are finding out the square root of this number, we will make pairs of 2. This 2 will form one pair. This 3 will form one pair. This 3 will form one pair. And this 3 will form one pair. So I will write this 2, I will take it as 1, 2 into this 3 as 3, this as 1, this 3 as 3. After multiplying, we will get 3 3s are 9 and 3s are 27. 27 into 2 is 7, 2s are 14, 2 2s are 4 and 1, 54. So the square root of 2 9 1 6 is 54. This we have done by prime factorization method. Second question of exercise 3B. In this question, you have to find the square root of the following fraction. First, we will write down this number is given. First, I will write down this number in square root. This is the sign of square root. Now, what we have to do is, I can write down 25 as 5 into 5. 25 is 5 square and 7 into 7 because 7 square is 49. Now what we will do? I can write down this 5 square upon 7 square. Then again I can write down this number as 5 by 7 whole square. As I have told you before, root of x, it is x to the power 1 by 2. Similarly, here it is given 5 by 7 whole square. So I can write down this as 5 by 7 whole square. If I remove this square root sign, it will be multiplied with 1 by 2. Here I will get this 2 and this 2 will get cancelled. And I will get 5 by 7 as the answer. Similarly, for this number, 0.009, it is. First, I will write down this number in square root. So what is the, if I multiply 0.03 into 0.03, this will be the square root of this number. I can write down this number as 0.03 whole square. Again, I will remove this square root sign, so I will write down 0.03 whole square into 1 by 2. This 2 and this 2 will get cancelled. I will get 0.03 as the answer. So in this way, we have find out the square root of the of these fractions. The third question is simplify. These numbers are given. We have to simplify this. So first, let's start. It's the square root of 5 square is 25. 4 square is 16. If I subtract 25 minus 16, it will be 9. Again, I can write down 9 as 3 into 3. This is 3 square. Remove the square root sign. You will get 3 square. If I remove the square root sign, I will multiply it by 1 by 2. This 2 and this 2 will get cancelled. And the answer is 3. Similarly, in the next question, here it is given. 4 by 9, I can write down 4 as 2 into 2, 9 as 3 into 3, and 81 as 9 into 9, 9 square is 81, and 10 into 10 is 10 square. So after this I will get, this will be 2 square, 3 square, multiplied by, this will be 9 square upon 10 square. Again I will get minus 2 by 3 whole square. Here I will get 9 by 10 whole square. This I will get 2 by 3, remove the square root sign, you will get 2 into 1 by 2. Again, remove the square root sign, you will get 9 by 10 whole square into 1 by 2. This 2 and this 2 will get cancelled. This 2 and this 2 will get cancelled. You will be remained with minus 3 by 2 into minus 9 by 10. Multiply this number, you will get 9 2s are 18, and this will be 3 10s are 13. When you will simplify this, you will get 2 9s are 18, 2 1s are 2 5s are, 3 3s are 9, 3 5s are 15. So the answer will be 3 by 5. This is question number 4 of exercise 3B. Here it is saying find the square root by long division method. This is the number, and this number you have to find the square root of this number by a long division method. So first I will write the square from 1 to 10. 1 square is 1, 2 square is 2, 4 square, 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16, 5 square is 25, 6 square is 36, 7 square is 49, 8 square is 64, 9 square is 81, and 10 square is 100. Long division method, first I have to write down the number in this way, 6, 7, 2, 4. Now the first step in this is make pairs of 2. This is first pair and here it is second pair. So in this question what you have to do, you have, this will be less than this number. Again if I will take 8 square, it is 64, it will be more about this number. But if I will take 9 square is 81, this will be more than this number. So if I am having 3 options here, if I take 7 into 7, it will be 49. If I take 8 into 8, it will be 64. If I take 9 into 9, this will be 81. So I have to take such number here that if I multiply this number, it should be equal to this number or less than this number. So if from these 3 options, which one is the nearest? This 8 into 8, 64 is the nearest one. So what I will do, I will write down 8 into 8 is 64. Subtract this number, what you will get? 4, 5, 6, 7, 3. Bring this pairs of 24 down. Now, here what you have to do, you have to add the same number which you have multiplied. So I will add this number, this I will get 8 plus 8 is 16. So by which number again you will multiply here? So you will get this number or you will get less than this number. So if I multiply this with 1, so it, I will get 161 only. If I multiply this number with 2, I will get 2 2s are 4, 6 2s are 12, 2 1s are 2, and this 3. I will get 324. So this number will get cancelled. So here I will multiply by 2. So I will write down 2 here. Again, 162 into 2 is 324. Subtract this number, you will remain with 0. In this way, you have to do the long division method. First, you write down the number in this way, from pairs, and you have to multiply with such square so that the number will be equal to the number or less than that number. In this way, long division method, you have to complete all the question of question number 4. This is question number 6. Evaluate. You have to evaluate the square root of this fraction. So first step, what will be the 2809? How can I write out this number in the form of square? If I write 53 into 53, I will get this number. Similarly here, if I multiply 64 into 64, I will get the square of this number. So after this, what you have to do? 53 square, you can write down like this. Again 64 square, again I can write down this as 53 upon 64 whole square. Remove the square root sign, what you will get? 53 upon 64 whole square multiplied by 1 by 2, this 2 and this 2 will get cancelled. I will remain with 53 by 64. So this is the answer, because further I cannot simplify this number. This is question number 7. In this question, you have to find the value of square root of 9216, and from this value, you have to calculate this. So first, I will find out the square root of 926. Square root of 9216. I can write down this as 9.96 into 96. Then again, I can write down this as 96 whole square. Remove the square root sign. For this, you will multiply this with 1 by 2. Cancel this. You will remain with 96. So what is the square root of 9216? Is 96. Similarly, I make this also. So for this, I will write, find out the square root of 92.16. Here I will multiply with, if I multiply this with it, 9.6 into 9.6, I will get this. So 9.6 whole square will be again 9.6 whole square into 1 by 2, square root will be removed. Again, this and this will get cancelled. I will remain with 9.6. Now I got the value of this. I will substitute in this. So after substituting, first I will write down this value. I will write down 92.16, square root of 92.16 plus 9.216. 92 square root of 92.16 is 9.6 plus 9.216. When you will add this number, you will get 18.816. In this way, we have simplified. First, I have find the square root of this number, because in the question it was given, find the value of this. After this, I need the square root of this number also. So I have find out the square root of this number. Again, I got this value. After this, after getting the value, I have substituted the value here, and I have solved this, and this I got the answer 18.816. This question, you have to find the square root of 2116 and 1764. First, I will find the square root of this number, and from that value, I have to calculate this. So square root of 2116. I will write down this in the square root sign. If I write down 46 into 46, I will get 2116. Again, if I write down 46 square, this square root and this square and the square root will get cancelled. So I will get 46. What is the square root of 2116? It is 46. Similarly, here I will find out the square root of 1764. Here I will write down, this is 42 into 42. I will get 42 whole square. If I want to cancel this 2 and this 1 by 2, it will get cancelled. I will remain with 42. So I have find out the square root of 2116 and 716, that is 46 and 42. Now I need this. For this, I will write down 0.2116 square root, it will be 0.46 into 0.46, you will get 0.46 into 0.46 is square root of 0.46 whole square, and here I will get the answer as 0.46. The square root of this number is 0.46. Now we have to find the square root of this number. I will write down 0.1764 square root. I can write down this as 0.42 into 0.42. Here it will be 0.42 whole square. So the answer will be 0.42. The square root of this number is 0.42. Now substitute these values in this equation. You will get 0.2116 plus square root of 0.1764 divided by square root of 0.2116 minus 0.1764. Now just substitute the value. 0.2116 is 0.46 plus here it, I will get 0.42 divided by this square root of this number is 0.46. Subtract this number, here it is 0.42. After solving this, you will get 6 plus 2 is 8, 4 plus 4 8, 0.88. Here you will get 6 minus 2 is 4, 4 minus 4 is 0, 0.04. Subtract this number, you will get 4 1 is 4 2 0. So answer is 22.